Biomass is a complex energy source consisting of several components. Normally, we can't go from biomass directly to a usable form of energy. Instead, multiple steps are needed. In this lecture, I will tell you briefly about a number of common processing steps. The typical so-called technology chain is that we start with a biomass resource, first do some pre-processing or pre-treatment, that's followed by the actual processing, which finally gives us a certain form of energy for end use, heat, power, or fuel. We will use this basic technology chain to give an overview of the different types of resources, pre-treatment, processing steps, and end use steps. Let's first have a short look at the sources. This can be first, second, or third generation. Examples of the first generation biomass are oil, sugar, or starch from crops, the edible elements from plants. Second generation are parts from plants that are not edible, such as lignocellulosic biomass and residues. Also, biodegradable wet wastes belong to this category. Think of the organic part of waste from households and manure, the droppings from animals from farms. And finally, we have algae, which are normally given their own category. They are called third generation biomass. In many cases, the biomass needs some pre-processing before the actual processing can take place. In many cases, this concerns physical pre-treatment. Think, for example, of drying to get rid of water from the biomass, or grinding to get manageable pieces. Sometimes torrefaction is applied, and this is a mild type of heating at about 250 degrees C to make biomass more brittle and easier to grind. In the specific case of oil from crops, we often need transesterification, a chemical reaction to get molecules that can be used as biodiesel. Then we come to the actual processing. This can be divided into two categories, on the one hand thermochemical treatment and the other hand biochemical treatment. The first category, so the thermochemical treatment, makes use of chemical reactions that run at high temperatures, several hundreds of degrees C. First example is combustion. This is simply burning the biomass and that's giving you heat. Then we have gasification. In that case, less oxygen is used. And as a result, we obtain gases that are oxygen-rich as a product. We can also turn the biomass directly into energy-rich liquids, and this is called liquefaction. Well, to be precise, torrefaction that I mentioned before is also a thermochemical technique. This is why we gave all these technologies the same color, orange, on the slide. The second category, biochemical treatment, is carried out using biological reactions. This involves living organisms, so therefore it can only be done at mild temperatures. Anaerobic digestion is the conversion of biomass into biogas, which has a comparable composition as natural gas, with methane as its main component. This runs without oxygen. Anaerobic literally means without air. Another technology is hydrolysis, followed by fermentation, to convert starch and sugar into liquid fuels such as ethanol. All these different technologies can yield different forms of energies. We can, for example, obtain heat, and that can be, again, converted into electricity. And since there's always some waste heat, it's often efficient that this waste heat is also usefully employed, for example, by district heating, combined heat and power. Biomass is also an important source for making sustainable fuels for vehicles. We will come back to that later. And finally, biomass can also be used to make chemicals. We talk about so-called platform chemicals when such a compound can be used as a starting point to make other chemicals again. This is typically done in a biorefinery.